I'm seeing you walking. I should get that urge. I say, wow, this girl is confident.
But confidence is confident. I feel like we're diving into another topic, but confidence is something that has to come to
from
a person
within.
And it has to come from within. Yes. And it has to be something that is progressive. Because me, I'm a plus size woman, you know. So some men will look at you and check in, oh, because you fat, once I talk to you, you should just accept.
That's
because
right.
They feel like I do not value self-love. My body because I fat. My brother is fat, I fat me, I don't kill nobody. So if you think because I fat, you're the first man that come in to talk.
That's right.
Bye bye.
Yes. Bye, Felicia.
Bye, bye.
Anything else?
So,
yes, thanks. Trying to escape from them, I guess, We try, then we just connect.
As a Dominican man, because since that's our topic, as a Dominican man, I believe that there are good Dominican men out there, like me, myself, but sometimes you have to learn yourself. Like me, I'm on this stage right now in my life that I am focusing on myself. I'm focusing on my self-love. I'm focusing on making myself happy. Because if I know how to make myself happy, I'll be able to give off that energy to a woman.
You cannot give what you don't have.
Yes. So I believe that there Dominican men do have the potential. But you know another thing that is very common? Peer pressure. We like to fit in. So we would treat that woman that kind of a way because we want our friends to come and laugh. You know, be cool, but at that time for that. You understand?
That's sad.
Women are... God made women for a reason. And if you don't take good care of them, then where are our children? You guys are our production.
No, please,
as well.
please.
You understand?
The Mega Man doesn't make children with anybody.
Yeah,
please.
But at the end of the day, you have to make it sense.
That's another thing about the Mega Man. You know, you meet a man randomly. After meeting a man for 1 week, he's telling you he wants you to make a child for him.
Ah. Oh, yeah.
But that has happened to me a lot of times.
Actually, I will take 4 Dominican men. They probably saw that you are beautiful, and she is beautiful. She's a beautiful woman. And they think that you can make a beautiful child as well.
Well, I know that,
so but
you know, making a child means you're bound to this person for life.
True.
That's why a lot of them make a child and then they come to the health center and they're telling you they cannot stand their baby mamas. You understand? So, priorities, and that's, I talked about this on my channel. The video has not come out yet, but I actually spoke about this, about the fact that Dominican men always making children. If you see 10 single men come to you to ask you out, 9.5 of them have children. Not some of them have 3 baby mamas. And that is the thing. But me, as an African, we are very much nuclear family oriented. Not just family oriented, as in I love my mother, I love my sisters, right? We want that, we have that mentality of go to school, marry, then have children. That's the mentality we have. So you will see single Nigerian men, I can tell you for a fact, currently I do not know any single Nigerian man that has children. Me personally, and we're over 200 million people in Nigeria, I cannot tell you one single man that I know that have children, that is not divorced or widowed, right? But in Dominica, let me tell you, most of the single, if I know 10 single men, 9 of them have children.
Right.
That's another thing. So you have to know, if I want to have a child with a man, I have to build a home with the man.
That's correct.
To have children with the man. But a lot of them are not that family oriented. You just see a fine girl and checking, oh, my child going to be pretty, and then you make a baby. It's more than that. I'm not bringing any child to a world in that situation. I wouldn't do that.
And I think also a lot of Dominican men, yes, we think that it is not something a man should do, but you see a praying man.
I don't know any single man in my church. I do not know any, maybe because I really don't check, but I really don't know any single man in my church. So I hope you all go to church, and I hope you all believe in God.
That's right.
And I hope you all really not just believe in God, but actually know God for yourself.
That's correct.
Because let me tell you, a believing man, a man that loves God, you don't have to worry about the man lying. You don't have to worry about the man cheating. You don't have to worry about...
You still have to sometimes.
No, if a man actually, and they're not polygamous, you know.
Yes.
I'm just saying that you do not, your first reaction when something happens is not like, oh, you're cheating on me. Because that this man actually believes in God. This man loves God. I'm not saying men that love God don't make mistakes, But you don't have to, pick your call, the first thing you have to say, oh, will you wait? That kind of thing. That is too much drama. So you have to like, love a man that loves God.
Yes.
And anybody that loves God doesn't want to fail God. The same way any man that loves you do not want to fail you.
That's correct. So yes, Dominican men, you need to, we need to book up ourselves. We need to, you know, take some time to understand women, because we tend to just go there quick and finish. But learn to understand your woman, Dominican men, so that we can get better reviews. Ain't it? So
understand. I don't think you're bad, you know. No, I'm not saying
I'm not
that.
Saying
like,
you're a bad
I mean,
one
Dominican, thing. I'm very open to dating Dominican. Yes. Like, I'm not that kind of a person. But at the same time, I have standards, and I'm not going to compromise my standards because somebody feel
right.
So yeah, I think there are some nice ones. I have a few Dominican friends.
Mm-hmm. She has a few Dominican friends.
A few Dominican men that are good. I have a few. That's it.
Yeah.
But I'm still single. Means you're not doing well enough.
Probably you're not going for the right ones.
Where are they?
They're probably there, but you're too blind. And that's the thing, is it? Women are sometimes too blind to see the goodness in front of them. And they will jump from this and that, looking up and down, when that one that was meant for you is probably your best friend.
I zoned out.
Very close to you.
I zoned out.
Don't worry. God is an amazing God. He puts... he just...
Was he trying to sell me on your channel?
No. I'm saying
I'm not
that
looking.
He plans situations to happen, to occur, so that, you know, you will get that one. And I pray, one thing I do is pray for Dominican women. I pray for Dominican men, because I feel like Dominican men, we're supposed to be leaders. We are leaders. We're supposed to lead the way. So I keep on praying for women. Parents, you know,
I feel like a lot of them need to get more exposed.
Meaning,
like, find out what different people are like. So don't just base every woman on a Dominican woman, because if you treat me like a Dominican woman, you might not get that, because I have different upbringing,
right?
Different beliefs. So like, to get exposed to know how to treat a woman. And I like a man that can spoil me, you know, because I spoil myself. As you can see, I look spoiled.
Yes,
and that's
yes.
not like my parents spoil me or things. I spoil myself. I take care of myself well. So you cannot have me looking like this. And then you're checking, you want to come to my life and not make me look better.
That's correct.
Or make me feel better. And like, you understand? You have to step up. Period. You have to step up. I'd rather be single than to be with a man.
So man to man, we need to book up ourselves. We need to pray a little bit more. We need to understand our women. Not everybody is easy. Or not everybody that has a ticket flying will say, hey, pick up the ticket or whatever. You know, some of us, we sometimes see this girl, we put the effort to ensure shows as our interest, and after we get that girl, that's it. You know, to be consistent. Consistency is the main key. You understand? So if I'm dating somebody, as a matter of fact, I am not at the moment. If I'm dating somebody, I will put my all. I have one thing they call trust issues. Trust issues is from the devil. That thing is from the devil, and I don't like to see that. I don't have trust issues. I just sometimes have a hard time of accepting what it is. You understand? So you see that trust issues, I cancel this out of my life. I just have to understand you, learn you, because I want to love you. I want to love you with that kind of enthusiasm. That enthusiasm I have about myself and about life, I want to be able to love you.
That makes sense.
Take care of you.
I saw a post that said that one of the things about human beings is that we know how to love, but we don't know how to believe we are loved.
Yes.
So that's the reason for trust issues. We know how to love, but we don't know how to. We have to get to a point where we believe that someone loves us. But the truth of the matter is, when you've been burnt before, when somebody has done you something before, it's a natural response to try to protect yourself and guard your heart and have trust issues. It's okay to have it, but it's up to that person to make you feel like you can let your guard down with me and be genuine enough to maintain what they say, so when you let the guard down, they do not come and hurt you.
Right.
Because a lot of men will say, oh, you have trust issues, you don't want to trust me, whatever. And the moment the woman trusts them, they turn out to be even worse than the reason why you did not trust them in the first place.
Mm-hmm.
So I think people have to be, and it's not just Dominican men, you know, I think
men in general.
People in general yeah. have to be, if you, women would appreciate, I would appreciate if a man come to me and tell me, oh, this is what I want. I would say no, most likely, right? But I would respect that you just telling me this is what I want from you, right? But if you come to tell me, oh, I love you, tomorrow you're telling me, oh, baby, first of all, I'm disgusted. And the next day you tell me, oh, I want to spend the rest of my life with you. And in actuality,
these are cheap ones, cheap ones.
And in actuality, you know what you come for.
Right.
So
if you come for what
I kind of have, I know how to discern those type of spirits. And I'm like,
that's where prayer comes in. Because you have to be strong. As a man, also, we have to be strong. Because at the end of the day, love is a complicated thing.
Strong.
Of course, as a man, you have to be strong. You don't have to be strong.
No, I don't have to be strong with my man.
Well, it's true. A man doesn't have to be strong.
No, it doesn't. Not necessarily if you're in a relationship. I'm not saying don't be strong, you know. I'm just saying that strong is relative because people have the, I mean, that's another thing about for men. People have the expectation that a man have to be strong. A man does not get vulnerable. A man mm-hmm. should not get emotional. And that's a lie. I want my man to be vulnerable and be emotional with me and be honest with me.
Yeah.
Right? People have that thing that, oh, you have to be strong. You don't
have
to be
strong.
When
I said strong, I didn't really mean like not showing. Because I'm a person, if we are dating, you would get all my emotions. You would, I even have my mood swings. You understand? So you have to just come up for the mood swings. I am very emotional for these days, especially as I'm praying at the moment and spending time with myself. I tend to get a bit emotional.
And that's okay.
And that's okay.
That's a lot going on.
As a man, that's okay.
Yeah, we have to talk about that as well at some point. As a man, it is okay
it's
to
okay.
be emotional. It is very okay. I like men that are emotional.
Okay.
It makes me feel... Well, I have a lot of them that would cry a river for you, but it's like they lie.
Yeah, it's tricks! Tricks,
they have.
And listen, they are good actors.
Oh, tell me about
good
it.
Actors,
some
eh?
That cry river.
But
they
yes.
will cry.
So how would you rate Dominican men in general on a scale to 10, 1 to 10?
I feel like this scale has to be like to my dream man. And the Dominican men I have met. So this is my opinion. I don't want all you to come for me and tell me, oh, look, the Nigerian says you don't like Dominican men.
She does.
So far, well, I have some Dominican friends that are really nice, right? Men that are respectful of women, they are nice. Like even some of the men that are dating my friends, I see that they are good men, right? So I don't think I can rate them because that just putting them into a stereotype of
right,
Dominican men. So they are good men, they are 9 over 10 men, and they are obviously minus 10 over 10 men. So
yes.
I can rate them. They are good men and then they are bad men.
Yeah, it's true. I mean, that's just in society.
In every country,
everything. Yes,
yeah.
They are good and they are bad. And that's just part of life. Good and bad.
I tell you, I there are some men right now that I can tell you I would rate minus 100 over 10. And I'm telling you, there are also some men that I would give 8 over 10 and give 9. 9 is a stretch.
Oh my God.
9 is a stretch.
So what would you give me over 10 now? Since you were talking.
Minus 100 over 10.
That's all right. She loves me. I know that.
I'm not giving her a rating.
She'll tell me after. I'll tell you what she said. So
yes,
guys. So yes. So as a Dominican man, I just want to leave that with you. Just believe in yourself, put God first always as a man, and treat women the way that you would like someone to treat your mom.
Your
that
sister.
I can say. Or even
or your
sister.
Daughter. Because all you will be there saying, oh, it's my daughter, that is my thing, you know, I just take care of my children. My children, that is my priority. And you go around treating somebody else's daughter like she's nobody's priority.
Yes.
And come on. Come on.
Let's not go there. But yeah, so I would treat my as much as I love my mom, and I can't wait to see my sister get big, or you know, I would really love that somebody will come to my home and say, okay, I am interested in your sister, and this and that and that and that. And I want that person to treat my sister with love, just like how God will love me, or love her, I mean, you cannot get close to that kind of a love, because that love is a kind of an elevation.
But that is the
love.
That is the idea,
love, you know? Right?
The Bible standard of love is love your wife, but love your wife as Christ
loves
it. So imagine if a man is loving me like the way Jesus loves me.
Yeah.
What else do I want in this world?
That's correct. So yes.
But all you don't want to put in all that effort, but you want all these
So this is the end of today. I just want to say, Dominican men, just do your best and just keep an open mind and treat my girl Tony with some love and affection.
I'm not looking.
But yes, so that's the end of it today. Thank you so much for joining me.
You're welcome.
Sometime again, we'll be seeing her, hopefully, to have another discussion, because this one was epic.
Yes, Chris.
So yes, thank you so much. Don't forget to like, subscribe, comment, and share anything you'd like to say.
Please like, share, subscribe, and of course, follow me on my channel and subscribe to my channel. It is Life with Tonye, T-O-N-Y-E. Life with T-O-N-Y-E. And yeah, watch another video.
So yes,
watch another video.
Thank you so much, guys, for listening, and I love you. You know, I always love you.
I don't love nobody on your channel.
She loves me.
When they come to my channel, I will love them.
And yes, this is the end of it today, guys. Stay blessed.
Yeah, that's it.